We have Nnamdi Obianya here with us. We want to talk a little bit about what's happening in NFF. The Appeals Committee started sitting about 2 days ago. They concluded their sitting yesterday and came up with some recommendations and a possible way for the NFF to move forward. Is the appeals sitting and the results have come with a distraction to the new executive committee? Well, all these things we'll look at. Nnamdi, thank you for coming.
Thank you for having me this morning.
Yeah, I'm sure you've taken a peek at what the appeals committee came up with. What's your take?
If I'm to be honest, I don't think they've really come up with anything.
Are you serious?
I tell you, I don't get Nigerian. I don't get Nigerian football. And I think the
the slides come up here. Giwa versus Nasarawa match day 35 fixture to be played on Friday, November 14th in Abuja. Giwa fined 1 million naira for negligence and must be paid before the match. LMC to offset the cost of Nasarawa's efforts to honor the bust feature. These are some of the results. Nembe's appeals against Lobi and Gombe thrown out. Ban on Nembe coaches, John Anka, and reduced.
Their bans have been greatly reduced. The main issue here is Nasarawa versus Giwa. This is why I said it's not covered with anything. First and foremost, finding Giwa FC 1 million. When before the season, the stipulated fine was 10 million naira. One of the study for Giwa FC is 1 million. Two, NFC saying they will bear the cost of Nasarawa playing the match. The match should be replayed. That's tomorrow morning at the God Project in Abuja. Here's my problem with this fixture. Giwa FC already had issues. They were bound to the Goal Project in Abuja. Nasarawa was to play them. Nasarawa honored the invitation, went to the FIFA Goal Project in Abuja to play Giwa FC. Giwa didn't show up. It's a home match for Giwa. They didn't show up again. Officials of the match performed a walkover. It's a simple rule. If someone doesn't come, you award the other person 3 points and 3 goals. But for some reason, the NMC had even said, okay, fine, we would have a walkover. But all of a sudden, there's been this U-turn. Now we're to have a replay again. Of course, Nasarawa is protesting this decision again because really, the walkover has been performed, which means they should have 3 points and 3 goals. Giwa is trying to get a continental ticket, so every fixture is vital. Now, the reason why I said they haven't come up with anything is because they've only put us into more trouble. They're giving Nasarawa more room to appeal. If Nasarawa appeals again, Warriors is waiting because it benefits them for Nasarawa not to get the 3 points. Then you can see you order the replay, why the U-turn. We have to finish our league. The end of next week now, we can't host our Federation's Cup. That will be postponed because that must come after the league ends.
And all the things that...
Everything is falling off because this fixture is not holding. Now, I don't know if it's tied to the fact that Chris Giwa owns Giwa FC. But for some reason, I don't know why Giwa is a secret car. We've seen many teams walked over. Sharks, Dolphins, Nembe, all these guys have been walked over in the past. At the point, we used to make the joke about how some teams would get relegated because of walkovers and some teams win league on walkovers. But all of a sudden, like this particular club can't be walked over. Right from the beginning, I don't know what was special about Giwa. First and foremost, the labor rules for the league. 100,000 minimum wage. Giwa said, we can't pay that. Giwa and Nembe, we can't pay that. We can only pay 70,000.
Yeah.
That way we can guarantee paying of salaries. At that point in time, he looked like an honest man, you know. The case was a case of when we're privately owned, we're not a government club, we're paying our money. Okay, come in and pay your players the 70K. They're still owing them. So right from the beginning, they're making concessions for Giwa right to the very end.
Yeah.
And now Giwa FC would more or less put the LMC, NFF in trouble because Nasarawa have genuine grounds for any protest they choose to stage.
So should Nasarawa refuse to play that match tomorrow, what happens?
Should they refuse, they might give Giwa the walkover.
So that means the table flips out?
Yeah.
Nasarawa will decide to go on appeal?
Yeah. That's where we'll go back to.
We're going back
in very, very large circles over and over again. That's all that is happening because this thing was settled long ago. Nasarawa got their 3 points and 3 goals and that should have been it. But sadly, it's not.
Besides this Giwa FC matter before the appeals committee, there were some other matters they looked at that had to do with the elections. Of the new NFL executive committee. Now, how do you think that played out?
It's a lot of, I think it's just a lot of aggrieved people looking for what I call a stay of execution. Let's look at Leonard Ibokwe, whose main grounds is the fact that Felix Anyasi won. but there's already somebody from his state on the executive's federal character is not being represented. And unfortunately, I cannot say my views on about federal character. I don't think I should use such colorful language.
Before you go, does federal character restrict anybody from vying for a particular position?
Sadly, when in Nigeria, when people don't have any proper grounds for anything, they start whipping up ethnic sentiments. It's been the problem in everything. We've chosen to sacrifice competence and ability on the altar of federal character. You know, you're talking about Pinnick and Akiyomi, about Southerners. You have Anyasi, who is from Abia. Someone is already on the executive committee, so he should have been voted in as the Southeast delegate. You know, it's all very funny. He's saying that Pinnick should be jailed for impersonating the NFF president because he's not the substantive NFF president. Oh, well. He says that they also circulated list of candidates before the election. It's a breach of article, I think 11.2, which states all campaigns should cease midnight before the day of election. I don't see how circulating lists of candidates is a campaign, except the list circulated was just a list of people that they are telling vote for these guys. But a list of candidates does not strike me as a campaign. But you know, these are all the funny things that are being used. And the big loser here is the NFF president and his executives, because they can't work. While all this is going on,
yeah,
the NFF cannot do anything. It's a huge distraction. When I came out and said Giwa and Kua are behaving like enemies of Nigerian football, some people challenged me, said I was being biased. But if you look at it now, what has the NFF done since the new board came in?
Yes.
Even what they've done has been overturned. You know, there seems to be this constant forward and backwards because they've not been allowed to settle down and do their job. Appeal today, appeal tomorrow. And it's getting very funny.
And the whole world's not waiting for us.
The whole world doesn't.
The world's not waiting for us. The AFCON qualifiers are on, and everything is moving forward.
Like Haratu said, does he understand why a big country like Nigeria always gives the biggest problems? I think people are tired of Nigeria's constantly flouting the simplest of rules.
That they signed on to.
The simplest of rules. You are a federation. You know what the rules are. You know what the FIFA statutes are. Chris Giwa coming in again when FIFA has recognized this board. You know, I've heard all sorts of funny things from the Giwa no proper representation, some funny rules were broken. You're looking for substance in this, but you can't find. I think at this point, Giwa should sit back. If he thinks he's the substantive president, he should go to the right channels. He said he has the case before CAS. CAS has not said anything. CAS has not annulled any election in Nigeria. CAS has not said any brought no injunction, nothing. But you're taking it upon yourself to say that the people there should not parade themselves as the executives.
But funny enough, he's not even gone to the appeals committee. He's not brought up anything before committee.
Neither did Barry Bote in his own time. There seem to be people who are willing to file these things. I just mentioned Leonard Ibukwe as one of them, an aggrieved. An aggrieved contestant from the elections. So these are the people who are actually filing these things on behalf of Giwa. And don't forget that Giwa himself did storm the secretariat, claiming he was the NFF chairman, claiming he will reinstate Keshi. You know, so he still has that mindset, you know. And I think we can choose to play politics, we can choose to speak from both sides of our mouth, we can choose to be diplomatic, but I think at this point it needs to be faced head on.
All right, let's leave the appeals committee and look at what's happening this weekend, the games that are coming up, both locally and internationally. What's your take? Let's look at Nigeria's game against Congo on Saturday.
Everybody got into camp. Inyama and Ake Uche, final people to get into camp. Ake Uche's first act in camp was to go and tell the press how much he wants to thank Nigerians, you know, do his whole PR. Well, it was time for training. Mikel, who people fear might not be fit for this game, was actually fit enough, actually scored in training. Emenike scored. And then Emmanuel Nidwok again, he can't stop scoring, scored in training again. So, feelers are high spirits. Everybody is ready to play. Who cares who would select, how he would line them up?
Nobody knows.
Nobody
but he has already said it, like he said in the papers, said, Congo will be a tough game, so he knows it's going to be a tough game for the Eagles. But how would you weigh this statement? Congo will be a tough game. Now, one, the Congo game is my biggest challenge in my coaching career. Two, another statement, I can do without Eagles' job. Now, three statements all from Keshi, allegedly.
allegedly.
Now, how do you think that will play out?
I think it's a case of his job just put forward that he has a nothing to lose mindset, but he wants the job. He really wants to do the job for Nigeria. I've always said it, that perhaps one thing we've always overlooked for a long time is the fact that Keshi might just be a patriot.
Yes.
We've always overlooked that, Keshi is mean, Keshi is vindictive, Keshi is trying to be more powerful than the NFF. But maybe he's just a patriotic Nigerian, you never know. Mukongo will be a tough game, I think he's stating the obvious. It's going to be very tough. First and foremost, they've defeated us already. Secondly, because we need every 3 points we can get, and we also need two goal margin and things like that for the final analysis, Keshi knows that every single game, no matter who we play, is going to be tough. So I think he's just stating the obvious. I don't want to believe that at this point in time I can do without Igwe job of credit to him. But if it was probably taken out of context, because Keshi's mandate is for the final two games.
Yeah.
So I mean, a question like, are you going to stay on after this? Would you want to stay on? Anything can be taken out of context from a reply to that question.
Mm.
So I really wouldn't want to attach too much importance to that statement. But I think Keshi knows task ahead, and he's probably motivated the boys. Problem is, will it show on the pitch?
Mm.
You know, the last match we saw the players rush to hug him when they scored. They are playing for him now. Amadu came in, probably saw that team was Keshi's team. That's why he went ahead to appeal for Keshi to come back. Keshi is back. Let's see how to play out. But Keshi's job is just one result away once again from another sack. But let's see how it goes.
Okay, let's look at the English Premier League. What do you think it's going to look like this weekend?
There'll be a postponement because of international break.
Yeah.
There'll be a postponement this weekend. But when they come back next weekend, it's going to be a very, very, very hot, particularly for Southampton. They'll be playing against, I think, Aston Villa with their hearts in their mouths, because after that, they have City, Chelsea, Arsenal, United all lined up. For Man United, they have to face Arsenal, two teams who are supposed to be powerhouses and are now in serious dilemma right now, trying to get their act together. For Chelsea, the steam roller continues continuously crushing everybody. Last week, as Wenger came out to say that Chelsea is uncatchable. I don't know if it's mind games, but Wenger is not known for mind games, but it's hard not to agree with him. It's hard not to agree with him. I'm looking for weakness in that side. I can't find.
All right. Thank you so much, Nnamdi, for coming. Thank you.